What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Oh, Foist! Nice. I like your accent today. Salad Dogs, what's up, man? How's it going with the game engine? How's school? Check out this rad area. Let me get to it. There it is. Look at this. Teak, yeah, that's me. Just singing in your web browser. Can't stream at 60 frames a second? It's ridiculous. Yeah, this area turned out pretty much by accident. I'm like, wow. This is beautiful. I like this area right here. It's like, wow. This is one of the reasons why I love creating procedurally generated game like this. Things that surprise you like this. Never planned for this. It just happened. Love it. So today I'm going to be doing a God mode playthrough. What world seed should I do? Give me a world seed. Any world seed. Six letters. It's all we need. So I can get rid of Ag. Tyrio? Alright, Tyrio it is. Tyrio! Here we go, Tyrio! Cheerio! We're going to do Tyrio! So yeah, I'm gonna do a God mode playthrough today because I need to cover pretty much the whole game. Well, yeah, pretty much the whole game, and only got so much time to do it because I want to do a release tonight onto Steam, and so I just need to check over everything. There's a lot of pretty significant changes that have been made to the game this week with all the elemental effects and a lot of other things. What's up, random number generator? What's up, man? So yeah, I'm going to get into the game here and then just put it in God mode and kind of quickly go through things because we got, you know, 10 different dungeons and a lot of things to check over. Rip? What? We ripped already? Looks like it's not rip. Grease right there. No, not as fun as normal, but still cool. Yes, it isn't. Not as fun as that playthrough the other day. That other playthrough was awesome. So one of the new things I think I fixed was this hold and skip. Just make sure that works. Yeah, that's cool. Alright. So from time to time, I'll be going out of God mode and into like regular mode just to make sure of the very basics, like right now. Tyrio, so this is the world you guys play, huh? Oh, this is interesting. Wow. I love the way it just puts patterns together in such surprising fashions. I never would have expected any of this. Oh, one of the big things that's new with this version of the game is that it fixed a lot of the enemy overworld patterns and the dungeon patterns. So, for example, these little green guys right here, they were almost completely missing from the game last version. So I found some code and fixed some stuff that basically enables all the enemy patterns to be as they were designed. So there's a lot more enemy patterns on the overworld as they were supposed to be. Okay, so far things are looking fine, so let me speed things up here. Died right there. Thanks, random. I'm calling you random number generator because of the RNG, the beginning of your name. Yay, okay, that works. This way. Teeks probably knows this whole world by heart. Gotcha! That guy's so much easier than the other little guy. Oh, this is so great. You can finally hit multiple bushes again. You could tell me where to go. Okay, so yeah, I'm doing it. Basically, this is a debug run. I'm not trying to do a speed run or anything. I need to basically experience as much as I can. Check this out. The mountains look so much better. The mountains inside these caves. But that wouldn't be fun. Might be fun for you. Inside the caves. Really, there's been a lot of work on the mountain tiles and the water. Floating around in that conversation. Oh, the black dot? That's probably was a little butterfly slash bat. It's pretty weird. The Button Masher Bros, when they first played this game and they did a YouTube Let's Play of it, and they called those mini TIE Fighters. From then on, I just call them mini TIE. They think of them as mini TIE Fighters. We don't need Teak to tell us where to go. There's a biodetector. Bow, 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 bow. Dead end. Even though I'm in God mode, I'm running really fast, I'm still kind of like trying to follow the path that you would as a player. So I'm just trying to make sure the game works. Essentially, this is messed up right here. Let's take note of this area. 620. I'm gonna note these things. Wizard Food just won 8 points, yes! The C key on your keyboard stopped working. That's so weird, because my keyboard stopped working this morning, too. Yeah, it needs cleaning. So we're at Tyrio 620, and we've got some weird bridge. It's a weird-looking bridge. Dungeon 1, here we are. Here we go. Whoa! This is some weird-ass bug that's been happening to me lately. Whenever I go into god mode, it like just makes the whole screen disappear all of a sudden. It's like black screen. I don't know what that is. Turn it around and shake it. Shake it like you mean it, man. Shake it harder. Some serious. What is going on? It's like my computer's about to light itself on fire. Oh yeah? You guess is this hard to get your what kind of keyboard you got? Do you have one of those Mac keyboards? Why is this taking so much CPU? I got something open that just doesn't need to be. Let's close Photoshop. Let's close TextMate. Terminal's not doing anything. Chrome, we can maybe minimize it. Man, this is like. You know your computer's getting hot when it's got a really, really, really high pitched whine. It's a Matthias. Oh, clickety clackety keyboard, nice. Whoops, this one invincible. Okay, these enemies are working. I'm not gonna mess around too much with them. Let's go god mode. Here we go. Oh no, the weird bug's back. It's only debug mode when I'm going in and out of god mode and stuff. This is one particular enemy I've got to fight, all of them. All these Verlocks, because they have all these different resistances and stuff now. And I've got to go craft an item, that's important. Sound, yes, just the sound alone. Songbringer? This is ridiculous. You guys hear that? When I'm normally developing, but when I'm doing that's what it is. Game show is using a lot of CPU whenever I go back into Songbringer. Okay, so it's not the game, it's game show with the game. Dude, this is annoying me. 130% of CPU. Okay. Alright, I was worried that I changed something and maybe made the game slower, but I don't think it's that. I think it's game show. Yeah, you can hear that? Alright, well, just hopefully it sounds like pleasant white noise to you. It doesn't sound very pleasant to me. Maybe I'll put my headphones on. Let's keep this in hearing. Love these new dialogue sounds. Yay, diamonds! Refracting the sprite handling? Should have done more research. Instanced rendering. Using the same vertex data. Okay. So now that you've got the experience developing that part, you're like kind of going back and you got some new thoughts. Going to make it better. I really respect how you keep on making it better and better. You're doing a really good job, I'm sure. Making this engine, man. I'm excited for you. This is Tyrio. I like Tyrio. What's that? You know what? What's that? No. Teeks is like, I know exactly where you can bomb right there. Watch out for the bombs! Yes! Oh, I love bomb rooms that show you secrets. That's so rad. Surprise. RNG, that's all thanks to you, man. Instance rendering only becomes performant when you're working with meshes that have hundreds or thousands of vertices. Oh, and you're just rendering four vertex quads. I see. So are you saying that you kind of coded something overkill at first? Yay. It's weird, God mode bug is so weird. I gotta fix that. Yay! Bio detectors are so useful. Like my favorite. Ah, okay. Hey, way to go, Jim. Picked up those 5 diamonds. I love it when Jim picks up diamonds. Yay, look at this. Bomb it. Bomb it. Salad Dogs, you're going to school, right? I didn't confuse you with somebody else, did I? Oh, check it. I can just exit the dungeon now. Let's go back and explore this room, too. Just to be all completionist about it. No, it was the key. Alright. Alright, one important thing is to fight all these bosses by hand. I am playing with the keyboard here. Oh, got the jump on you, man! Got the jump on ya! Bomb right whenever you stop, which is so perfect. You're undoing the overkill. Oh, okay, cool. So that'll make your sprite batching system more effective. Sweet. Okay, no issues with that boss. He's all good. that, I don't think I really had any. Well, I don't have any elements anyways. What does it matter? Yay, I leveled my garb. Love the health. Yes, me too, dude. I love that thing. There's a couple things in the game recently that just like a really bomb. Really improved stuff, and that's one of them. Ah, okay. Yeah, oh, yeah, you are going to school. What are you going to school for? Store. I got plenty of money right now. Weird bug. I don't know what that is. Oh, comp sci. Alright. You probably know everything already. Yeah. Yep. Bikes are bad. Are you cheating? Yes, I am. I gotta get good. I'm just cheating because I need to run through the game as fast as possible. I gotta get through this whole game. It's totally sporadic, yeah. Oh, does it not happen in dark rooms? That's a good question. That's a great question, Mutinous. I'd love to get to the bottom of this thing, because it's kind of just messing up my whole god mode flow. Yeah, Yep. I don't know what this is. There's like some little secret that keeps showing up. It's kind of weird, but not a big issue. You're still taking it seriously? What for? I'm joking. Yeah, because you're really being late for the diploma. As you should be. Good. That's good. You gotta take some things seriously. Especially when it comes to, like, education, your future. I'd really love to do is in the game pretty soon. Oh, there it did it again. One thing I'm going to do pretty soon is work on the shadows as you transition. If you notice, where's something you can really notice it? There, you can see those shadows that right here. These shadows for these bushes. If you want to transition from here to here, they double up because there's actually, you know, an entity on this screen, an entity on that screen, and then they double up. There's gotta be some way to fix that. I'm sure I'll find it. Just anyways, the transitions between screens, I'm trying to work on making that more seamless. So that'll be in probably in the next update. I'm just trying to find any bugs that might be in this version so I can get this version out tonight. Shadow drawing for that entity on the new screen until yeah that's a good way to do it. I'm sure there's a really simple solution to it. I bet you there's a secret on this screen. Let's see if we can find it. Did I drop some? There we go. Nice, found it. Yeah, got a calculus pouch. Yeah, you do. You understand the problem. Yeah, that was a perfectly reasonable solution. the likelihood of finding a secret in this first swordless dungeon is really high because there's so few rooms. So it's like if you go and you try and find a secret in this dungeon in particular, you're probably going to find it. Not this one though. There's got to be there's probably a secret path somewhere. Can't be your credit card. Uh-oh, I thought I found it, but no. Cheat mode. Oh, there it is. Oh, the one place I didn't try. Right? It's always the one place you don't try. Yes, this is totally not God mode. You just walk through that. Okay. What do you do? Call it quits on this dungeon. Oh, Deeks is like, yes, you're showing me where the secrets are. The God mode could be a DLC. Cash it, that's a really good idea. I've been trying to think of like... I'm trying to think of DLCs I could give away for free to people. Like, you know, like, hey, thanks for being a fan of the game for so long. Here's a free DLC. That would be a good one. Oh, cash it. Genius, man. Genius. Oh. You already knew that? Yeah, you did. It's because you guys are thorough. So I'll have you know, Teek, I fixed a couple bugs recently that could have changed the entire world, but they didn't because I thought of you. I found some solutions to some bugs that were like... It's kind of really helpful to think about, okay, how can I fix this bug without breaking the entire, all the other existing worlds? Because it kind of makes your solutions more flexible. And in this case, it was a bug where, I think it was world AAAAAAE. That world, you couldn't get to dungeon one without having, because it blocked your path with some bombable pillars. And, yeah, I found a way to, instead of changing the world or failing that world or whatever, I made it so it just changes the gate. Like, you know what, in these rare cases, you might as well just change the gate to an easier gate so you can just still complete that world. Oh yeah, some tiles are different now. Yeah, some tiles are going to be different. Yeah, that's true. Tiles and also the enemy placements. So yeah, sorry about that. Some of these enemies are going to be different. But the overall structure of the world has not changed. The overworld and the dungeons, they will all have the exact same structure. So far, so good. But one of the most important things I've got to do on today's playthrough is go play enemies that have elemental stuff. Elemental... enhancements, resistances. Star, what's this got? Got an element? I need an element. I need some elements, so like, yes, here we go, fear. Oh, now I don't have enough. Are you gonna wait? Oh, I think that's smart. Yeah, I think it's smart, because I'm probably gonna change stuff. Oh, the shop. Oh, I don't. They might. Yeah, they might have. I don't. What would have changed to actually change the shop items? Oh, rent. Yes, you're right. You're right. Yeah, I did make one change to all of the random numbers on each actual screen. It was kind of a bad, it was a bad situation. I had coded this one thing to make all the random numbers either even or odd, which is really stupid, which caused like a whole bunch of really predictable situations to happen with your with the random numbers. Yeah, the shop was different. Sorry about that. But it's for the better. It's for the better. That means all the random numbers in the game are more more random. They're properly random now. And if anybody's curious what I'm talking about with the random numbers, each this is a procedurally generated game, and it's got to be deterministic, right? So every time it generates a world, it's got to be the same world every time. The secret to doing that is to one way to do that is every single one of these areas, like this particular screen right here, has, you know, like 20 by 20 tiles about, right? And each one of those tiles has three different random numbers that get baked into the world at the very beginning. So that's what I'm talking about with the random numbers. Looks like I can go up that way without cheating too much. Don't report all the glitches. Yes, don't. Did you see that glitch I put on Twitter? It's a sweet glitch where you freeze some water and then you can walk on water after that. It's Christmas. It's Christmas because we just got a flask. One of the most bestest items ever. I think I'll save my money. Let's go this way. Oh, that was dungeon one. Never mind. Oh, hey, we got this now. What? Secret? No item? That's bullshit. Lame. What happened here? Okay, I'll have to debug that later. Once again, this is exactly the same area as that other one I just reported, 620. Let's get this in there. That's gonna be nice when I go back to clean these bugs up. I can be like, hey, same exact area, don't even gotta set it up again. This is, what's this? Puzzle pattern yields. No item! Exclamation point. Totally messed up. Went through all that effort. Yo, what's up? Which one did I fix? I can put it back in. I'm trying to leave the good glitches. Okay, so since I can't get through there, I'm not gonna. Twisted little path. I'm gonna save for later. This looks pretty interesting. I like how that was all twisty there. And I love the pits, man. I love these deep, dark, black pits in these dark forest areas. So cool. It's so much of a feeling of height. You didn't even tell? It was an invincibility bug? What was that? Oh, here we go. What the hell? Was it the one where you could keep blinking and blinking and blinking and you're invincible while you're blinking? That one was kind of too much of an exploit. Okay, we're finally in an elemental place. There's some, we gotta pay attention. Swing and a miss. Which door? Should I take that door? Oh, hey, lucky. Oh, damn it! Oh, I can't. Okay. Oh, it's correcting itself. That wasn't too bad. Blinking into the first boss while he was at lower left gave you... Really? Oh, that sounds awesome. I don't know how that got fixed. I did not intentionally fix that one. Once again, I don't have anything crafted, so it really doesn't matter. It's not like my sword does any less or more damage, because I don't have anything crafted on it. What's up, Boogs? Howdy, partner. Doing a little God mode playthrough here, just trying to get through the entire game thoroughly, as quick as possible. Testing out the new elements. Oh, after the blink rework, okay. Oh, I forgot these guys could be in the dungeons now. I'm not exactly sure how. They're scary. They're super scary. The only way to beat them is the... I do have fire at this point. This is fun. Die, you scary overlords! Oh man, this is dangerous. Fear does a lot of damage. Yeah, I got one! Oh! Killed him! That was tricky. What that? This room had been broken. Without the latest, it might have been. There's a bug fix recently with this room, this kind of room. Okay, here's some fiery guys. Okay, wait, if I hit them with the lighter. Oh, they just have fire resistance then. This would be the ultimate challenge, trying to beat the whole game with just a lighter. Oh my god, this is going in the achievements. Somebody out there is gonna do that. I don't know how you would beat the fire boss though. Maybe you'd use your sword for the fire boss, I don't know. Or the top hat. Top hat's not as... Okay, so I don't think I'm hurting them. Either that or I'm hurting them very little. I don't know, it's kind of hard to keep them straight. They're like cups being swirled in front of me. Big stuff. Missed this very important first area back here. To flick your big achievement, yes! Oh yes, you got the name already. No other name shall ever be considered. Overlords. I'm gonna cheat. These overlords are kinda... Wait a minute. Oh, this is really dangerous. I'm not sure if I can leave this in. Oh wait, I just need to... Oh, okay. I need to add a restriction to that. Okay. Let me note this. This is very important. The overlords need to have... need to be in unlocked rooms. Because if you got stuck, if you got locked in a room like that with those guys, and you didn't know that you could use, or you didn't even have the lighter yet, that would be a bad situation. So that's definitely the most important bug fix so far. That would be really frustrating as a player. You're like, oh my god, what? How do I can't get through this room? Either you wouldn't be able to, or you just couldn't because it's really hard. That one would have been really hard. Four of those guys, I fought two of them and it was hard. Here we go, here's a fiery room. Fire element. Lighting these guys on fire doesn't work. Oh, I know, the copyright infringement? Oh! Think of that. Down for the count. What happened? It's the jib debug error. It's just a debug thing. Only happens in debug mode if you had turned on the debug view and then you restart the game. Sometimes it crashes. Oh no, what? Oh, this is the other error, the other world. I'm like, what happened? Okay, I gotta speed this up. I'm already on Dungeon 3 and I gotta get through 7 more. Can't do more. I can't be going as thorough anymore. Everything is pretty much working. I need to focus on enemies that have elemental effects, and I need to get some. I need to craft an item, so I need to go get some. I need to go get something to craft. Where am I? One little guy. Should have killed him. Should have left him alive. dies anyway. Yep. That's how you know it's a good game. When you still die. Racking up the I got 255 diamonds. I gotta buy something on the next overworld run. Should be some secret. Wasn't it? Okay, here we go. This guy's elemental. He's got some elemental effects. If I try and light him on fire. Yeah, see, he got healed from that. I got lucky and actually hit him with that. Oh wait, maybe I did. Maybe he just got hit with the bonfire. Yeah, there we go. I definitely hit him with the lighter that time, and he got healed. Okay, so, fighting this guy with his ability to heal. Ah! What's up, okay? Is this guy harder? That's the question. What's his hit points at? Is that about to die? Nah, I almost had him. Kind of hard, I will admit that. He's maybe a little bit harder now that he heals a little bit from his own fire. He doesn't always heal from his own fire, that's good. It's kind of like when he gets stuck in a corner or something. Really? Really? I didn't know that about copyright law in games. So, flick your pick. You're saying I might be able to get away with it, huh? Probably wouldn't chance it, but maybe I could come up with some kind of funny word that sounds like Bick or was very close to Bick. Some of them are coming to mind immediately. Gotta go fast. Oh, we got the Santa comment. Yeah. Get another comment, please. Chat. RR. That's a good one. I love that one. So good. Okay, we need an element. We gotta craft something. Because it's time to see whether this craftiness is affecting the game. Alright, we need an element. Give me an element. There's a store right there. Does it have one? No, that's not a store. Does that look? Secret. Okay, we need stores. Stores. We need to explore. Exploring! It'd be nice to have something crafted before. Oh, you know what? I know where this one of the elements is. It's in that one store down here. What should I craft with fear, huh? Maybe we usually craft things with fear that much. Fear is gonna be pretty powerful though. I don't have the ghost sword yet. I got the top hat, bombs. Fear bombs might be pretty interesting. Or the fear top hat. Recommendations or the fear blink. All of these things are. What's up, Fears? 1 year, huh? Welcome back to the stream, man. Okay, fear blink or fear top hat or fear bombs. Game ready yet? Nope. Okay, blink it is. Blink. Saladong's fear blink? Alright, cool, that's what I did. Nice. This will make the fear blink, or when I blink, it'll make it more damaging, and it will cause enemies to panic. Panic! This is a total shortcut. That guy was panicked. He's like, I don't know where to go. All right, lurk time, sleep time. Yeah, I like this audio too. I'm trying to do a lot of ambient audio. Because I typically get tired of listening to game music. I'm like, whoa, this game's got awesome music! And then, like, you know, an hour or two later, I'm like, shit, I'm turning the music off because this is, I've heard this song over and over and over. Yeah? You like it? Cool. I'm glad it's captured you that way. It really has done so for me, too. It's really one of the most interesting dungeons because it has more secrets than ever than any other dungeon. It's always the same shape, but it's really so twisty because you got all these tunnels. Okay, if I continue playing this though, I'm gonna get the blink orb, which I might get right here. Oh my god, I got it. All right. That's pretty powerful. Now I got a, now I got the fear blink and it's upgraded. All right, I'm gonna go back to back to the game though. Back to the rest of the world. Yes, procedural music. Exactly, man. It's on my list. It's on my list. And in fact, after long, long, long time waiting, next week is the week I start procedural audio. Ugh, I can't wait. I got a lot of ideas. I really don't know how it's gonna turn out. You like the golden palette, yeah. I do too. It definitely looks a lot better than Songbringer used to. It's like the ship, I mean. Do we have enough for the proton? Nope. Okay, we've got, all right, that was a good place to go, because, oops. The new Doom soundtrack, really? I gotta check it out. Has anybody played Goner? I really like the soundtrack from that so far, from what I've heard. I haven't played Goner though. Just wonder if anybody has any thoughts. I'm pretty sure it's like a roguelike, like you basically whenever you die, you have to start all the way over. Music that changes with gameplay? Can you think of a good example of a game like that? Seamless music, yeah. Really? In the spectrogram? No way! Oops. That was weird. Terraria? What's up, Brecon? Hello! What? Really messed that up. I think I... Oh, no, I lost it. I gotta go all the way back. That was a weird one. I actually warped to Songbringer and then couldn't warp back to the old place in the overworld. HL2's soundscapes, huh? This one? This one. The chat is just like, it doesn't show the history anymore whenever I go to this. Lame. 17 minutes long, game laws? Oh, on game laws, okay. Got it, got a link to it. Okay, where was I? This way. Ugh, whoops. It's like a hole, go inside the hole. It's just like golf. I was trying to get this secret right here. And then I was like, use the lighter, but it was the teleporter. I wish I had fire. I love crafting fire. Running a chatty? Oh. Cool. I should check that out. It's like only lighting some of these on fire. just looking for secrets because I fixed a lot of secrets recently. Just want to see if it worked. This is taking forever though. Oh, the last one. Oh, nice. Found it. Yo, I'm just racking up the cactuses here. Okay, I got a lot of game to finish here. Adaptive soundtracks. Sweet. Thank you, guys. Thank you for these awesome thoughts and links. Next week is going to be super exciting. I'm so excited to do procedural audio. It's been a long time in the coming. Weird bug. I got to fix this. All right. So I have something crafted at least. But once again, this is something that's not really going to affect much of the game. I'm really not too worried about the whole elements doing more or less damage anymore. What was that? That's so weird. It's like it slides. Oh. You can, when you slide to a stop, it goes along the edge of the area. That's so weird. I need to note that. I was wondering what that was the other day. Sliding to a stop based on friction doesn't allow you to slide into the next area. It's just a little thing, but it will make a big difference, I'm sure. But as a player, you're like, what is going on? Why? What is this? Oh, no. Does this always happen right then? These little guys. These guys are tricky hard. Some of them freeze you. They're super quick and fast, and then you gotta beat them all before the time limit. Duh. Is actually pretty handy. Yeah, this is a pretty powerful weapon now. You do damage right when you hit him, you cause him to be panicked, and you do damage after a minute. Oh no! I don't want to have to fight these guys again. No, I did! Oh! This guy's hard! It's too hard! I don't know, I might need to actually up the time on this guy. Because you get frozen so often, and then you're just stuck there, all frozen. You're done! Oh, man! That was kind of hard, actually. Oh, the jibdy bug. I didn't really do this very fast, did I? This whole God mode playthrough thing. I'm not sure if I can actually get through the whole game right now. I'm already losing steam. Come on, I can do this. I can do at least a couple more dungeons. Oh, that was genius. Maybe not. The lighter with the blink only. No sword. That worked! Kill him before he closes his eyes. Yes! Oh, no sword. That was easier of a fight that time. I don't know what that was. Why was that just... Did that strategy actually work that well? What's up, Rocket Bunny? Welcome to the stream, Rocket Bunny. How you doing, Rocket Bunny? What's new, Rocket Bunny? Okay, I got really got to get into God mode here and do some God mode-y stuff. Oh, another example of an enemy pattern. Oh, yeah. Actually, that should be noted too. So, those guys. Or else, they can always be in the advanced dungeons. Once you've got some stuff crafted and you're better at the game, you might get dry eyes. Oh, catch it. You're on fire today, man. What's up, Hansi? Welcome. For the data, no, I used a data format called Valtree, something I wrote for the game. You've probably seen me use it many times. What's up, Scissor? This is a God mode playthrough. I'm just trying to rip through the game, as much of the game as I can in today's stream. Which means I'm going into debug mode, God mode, a lot of the time. But still, I'm trying to follow the path that you would as a player. Just trying to basically debug the game as fast as I possibly can. Yeah, Valtree. There you go. Wow, here's a really this is a great example of a dungeon urban area that shouldn't be there right now. Those guys are kind of cool to put in these different dungeons, but I mean outside the swordless dungeons, but they are too hard. You need to have fire. You really need to know what you're doing. Hear that? Or get lucky. Must be a good sign for finishing development if you're doing a full playthrough? No, it's not. It's not. I'm not even near finishing development. Am I the only tester? No, there's plenty of testers. A lot of the people here in the stream are playing this game too, and they're helping out test it a lot. Wonderful testers. I got the best testers in the world, man. Oh, nice. Let's do this. Okay, no God mode here. Just... Hard to port for Android? Yes, it is. It is very time consuming and difficult to port for Android because Android has a huge device fragmentation and it's very hard to do shaders well for Android. So you might have written your shader well and it works awesome on Windows, it works awesome on Mac, it works awesome on Linux, and it just is pure shit on Android. Android is like one of the hardest things to get your shaders right, and a lot of other bugs you just never would have thought you would have had on Android. This is almost guaranteed a secret room right down here. Is it? No, it's not. My spider sense is off today. Okay, god mode, I gotta go quicker. I'm only on dungeon 4. It's locked. No key? I missed the key? I missed all the keys. It was right up here. Cheated. But. Oh, that was a secret path. I wasn't even cheating. Nice. When will it make its debut on the Switch? Oh, that's a dream, right? That would be cool. That would be pretty cool. I don't know. What do you guys think about the Switch? What are your thoughts so far? What's everybody thinking? Switch yes, Switch no. Okay. I don't need to fight everybody. I just need to test everything. It's so easy to get caught up in playing everything. You're pretty impressed. You don't like the dedicated machines, just for games. Game selection. Yes, game selection. Very, very important, isn't it? What do we got here? It's a neat room. But once again, I don't need to wait for this. Okay, turning off God mode to fight the ice boss. Wait a minute, could I have walked onto the sky right there? I might have been able to. Whoops. Oh, frozen! Oh, double frozen! Want to do the eSport development? Yeah. How will they do with that? Right? They really kind of played that up on their whole video, didn't they? On the Nintendo Switch trailer. They're like, look at this! eSports on Nintendo! But does anybody play eSports on Nintendo currently? Or was that just something they're trying to, like, get us to think that they're... Wow. Are you weak to fire? You gotta be. I'm gonna use the liner on you. It supports Unity. Really? Now that's big. That's a big step for Nintendo to make that step. That was pretty good English of me, huh? Oh no, I'm so dying. Oh wait. Lighter still. Uh-oh. Oh, Unity supports it, yeah. Bombs. That was a good dodge. Not this thing. Oh no! Yes. Out of there. Damn it, he's so good at hitting me. Oh, really? I didn't know that. They'll charge. $150 for a Switch or exporter? Definitely. Yeah, Yeah, they do that per platform, don't they? They're like, hey, you want to export to mobile? Here you go. Oh, this is, phase two is difficult. Oh no! Oh damn! Take it down, by Lasorium. VR. But are they really kind of a VR company, or you know? They seem more like a portable company to me, like a portable handheld. Okay, that was definitely more difficult than I remembered. Either that or I just suck. I gotta get good. Oh, man. Dude, I'm just getting worked. Near it. Most likely bomb on esports. It's true. Yeah, about Super Smash Brothers. First person Mario. It is kind of a gamble, huh, VR? I'm really wondering how Sony's gonna do with it. Oh. Yes, Arcane! Yes! A 2D Metroid! I don't think they'll do it either. Why don't they do any 2D? A 2D Zelda would be sweet too! But no. Probably never again. Oh man! So easy to slide into that. Just in time. Damn it. Did I like Wind Waker? Sure. I like all the Zeldas for what they're worth. I haven't played the newest one, Twilight Princess, so I don't really know. Can't comment on that one. I heard it sucked, but I don't. Yeah. That might be good information or bad. You made your own font? Yes, Steffi, I made all my own graphics and everything for this game. Oh, cel-shaded Metroid? I think Lasorium might be a little too difficult now. Because I don't have cold armor anymore. Or I think cold does a little more damage than it used to. Yeah. I need to tone down the difficulty here. Difficult. Technical. I am playing with the keyboard, I guess. That makes it a lot harder. Did I already... Holy crap, I used all my... Ow. Wow. Wow. Any tips for making a font sprite sheet? Yeah, I got some. If you're having issues with blurry text, I think the font sprite sheet would help. Oh, well, if you have blurry... Oh, wait, is it blurry text because of you're not using nearest neighbor? You got to make sure when you're doing fonts and you want them to be pixel art like that, you got to use nearest neighbor. Because if you use bilinear or any other kind of like filtering or whatever on your stretch, when you stretch it, you'll get the blurry fonts. Sorium is definitely too difficult. This is a really hard fight now. A freezing exception should be added for both the player and mobs. A freezing exception? What do you mean a freezing exception? Like just back to back? Like you can't really be frozen back to back? Because it is really difficult. I think I increased the time or something. Oh, it's a Game Maker exporting to Android, huh? Okay, anyways, I've fought that guy too many times. I'm just gonna cheat. I must continue my debugging quest of debugging. About this area, if walking in here, if you can walk in from right here on the side, you can walk onto the sky right there. That's a bug too, which that's kind of a cool bug, but it's not really that useful. It's not a useful glitch. All you would be able to do is run around in that room on the sky, and the second you got back on the ground, it would force you to be there. So anyways, I'm going to fix that glitch, I think. It's not really a cool glitch. Oh, yeah, consecutive freeze. I got you. Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to play with that. You like it? Thanks, Salad Dongs. I got some comments saying people didn't like it, the first part of it, but I really liked it. And I was like, you know what, I'm just gonna keep it because I freaking love it. It was totally inspired by Super Mario Brothers. When you get the mushroom. Acid, here we go, I'm gonna craft something. What else am I gonna craft? Either the acid top hat or the acid go sword. Yeah, stop freezing bosses over and over. I think I've already got some code which basically does that. It must not be enough. Like it takes off an enemy or a player's the flag to be able to be hit by a certain element for a little while, but it's probably not enough. It's not like enough time so that it can't be done back to back. Oh, so you like the fringe product. Cool. Nice. Yeah. It's weird how when you go with like a certain idea, something will kind of not work for a long time, and then sometimes it will turn out where it just doesn't work. You know, you're like, ah, gotta ditch this, it's not gonna work. But sometimes it ends up working in the end, and you're like, you know what, now it finally just clicked, and I guess I just crafted the ghost sword with acid, so it's gonna be the acid sword. Didn't even think about that. Well, that'll save the top hat for fire. Fire top hat would be pretty neat. Or the ice top hat. All right, I am quickly losing steam, but I think I can at least do one more dungeon. Oh, you know what? I just noticed the, teleport cube doesn't have a reflection. That's a really, really quick and easy fix. It took like 2 seconds. Follow that guy. Oh, wait, hold on a second. Something about that. I could probably refine that. So, using meditate successfully stops the current music playing. Do 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 do. Flag is taken off for full freezing or replacement effect should step in so you don't feel like ice sucks for using or facing. Oh, right, right. Yeah. So it's like a diminished effect. Which is the opposite of the poison. I will definitely play around with that. Come up with some kind of balance there. Oh, hey, is it nighttime? It is! Yes! Where is the secret? Where is it? I don't see the secret. What? Huh? Where is it? Oh, there it is! Yes, this shield! That was a good secret. We got 2 shields now. I freaking love these new areas. Zero. Walking on the cliffs. I guess he could do that. He's like half corporeal. Half not corporeal. Incorporeal? Is that the word? Incorporeal? That doesn't sound right. He was. It's like, hey, come on up here. Is animation a needed thing to reach a minimum viable product? I guess that largely depends on whatever the product is. You know, some games are the crappiest graphics ever. Oh, that would have been nice to get right before that last dungeon. Do, 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 do. Oh wait, I already had the shield. Oh wait, this is where I would get the shield. Okay, I've got shield level 1 right now. Whoa. Hey! Hey! Nobody's trying to get hurt around here, no! Hey! Whoa! Oh good, this little bug fix here. That would have been an... Had I not fixed a certain bug this morning, this area would have not had this little path around it. Yes, he should. Yes, he should. There's a lot of story elements which are not done yet, and next month is going to be story month like crazy. So this month was kind of like refining the overworld. His worry emotion has been short-circuited. Yeah, this month was kind of focused on the overworld, and next month is all going to be focused on story elements like crazy. And in December, I'll start working on refining the dungeons and making them even better. Whatever I can do to make them better. Weirdness. Weird black screen. That freaks me out so much. Why does God... It just started doing it the other day, too. It's like... It must be something related. This other bug with that not hitting. So let's make sure this pattern. Swordless to pattern with shield towers surrounded by. Toggle pillars can be lowered if you stand close with pillars up. Yeah, there's a lot of story elements planned for throughout the game, and then there's also a big story elements towards the end of the game. So most of those I will be doing in November, but I'm going to save the very, very ending, the ending cutscenes and the very last story elements to go into the tower. That I'm going to save for very, very last. So yeah, the game will get most of its story next month. Scary. Yay. That was weird. It didn't do the courage up animation. I think it's because I blinked into it. Blinking onto life container, courage container, something like that, causes animation to not happen. Rock's animation in particular. Okay, I got another dungeon in me. Just one more dungeon. Which one? Which one should I do? I wish I could find... Let's see if I can find a store. There's probably a secret there. I can't find too many secrets. I'm excited that a lot more secrets are... Hey, cool! Whoa. Whoa. faces. Yeah! Well, it'd be nice if you could hit those. Found the tower. There it is. It's right there. What's this? Oh, hey. That's going to be a story element. Interesting world here. I love this, man. I love this. It's so fantasy. You got water right there, and then all of a sudden there's just this deep pit. I love the deep pits. Love them, love them, love them. Okay, I totally could have done that. I don't know why I just did that. Didn't need to. Hey, what's that? It's probably a secret. Man, not really looking out finding the stores. Where are they? There was one. Okay. Nice. What do we got here? I need some elements. Fire! Yeah! That's what I wanted. No, what? I have enough? Give it to me, man. Sell me this thing. Woo! Alright, fire top hat. Here we come. Or fire bombs. Fire bombs! Let's do fire bombs. Probably should go do the next dungeon, which would probably be the acid dungeon at this point, because none of the dungeons are randomized yet. This doesn't sell your kind. You gotta stand closer to the switch, man. Can't be all disrespectful like this, standing off the switch, expecting me to sell things to you. Who do you think I am? That I can, yay! It's gonna come in handy right now. Put some respect on it. All right, there we go. Last dungeon. Mutinous, 2 days in a row. So how would I get there? Go around here. Rigged. Thank you. It looks like this way. Yes, found it. Whoa, hey, whoa. Oh, did I note that the ice verloc was too hard? Okay, this is kind of interesting because I've crafted the ghost sword with acid, which I can't remember if I added acid heal to any of these guys. Why is that guy just sitting there getting hit and hit and hit? Been a bug introduced with the related stuff. Either that or there's a scorpion which burrowed and never came back up. What's going on? This is so weird. Okay, I think I found a bug. Yeah, that's probably a bug. You can add to the cannot win list. Oh, for mutinous? Oh, maybe it did. It's just dancing. All right, I should note. Oh, you know what? I'll just save my current save file. Wait, I'm not sure if I have this save file. Wait, I'll save. Quit. Copy my save file. Name this something descriptive. Acid Burlock, for example. And there. Okay, now to confirm this, I'm gonna go back in and see if it happens twice. Yeah, it didn't happen twice. You might have been right about that, Mutinous. Whoa, that was a lucky ass bomb for sure. Yeah, he might have just had a little dude burrow under him. I hope. That's gonna be a difficult one to reproduce if it doesn't happen every time. Yeah, another element! Ice! Let's go craft something. I guess it's gonna have to be the top hat. Crafted everything else. Well, the ice top hat is freaking super useful. Oh wait, did I note that bug? There we go. Yeah. Acid timer interacting poorly with invincibility. Oh yeah, that could be it. Yes, good thought, very good thought. Let me note that. Hopefully something simple like that, where, yeah, as soon as I can find a way to reproduce it every time, then I'll be like, oh, there it is. And it might have been that. It might have just been the acid. Because I did get hit with... I did have acid, but also the little scorpions have acid. And that might have somehow interacted with him. Her. What is this? Oh, did I already find the stairs? It's beautiful. I did. Oh, no. Walk straight. Look at that. Straight to the verloc and the stairs. The gods of game development are shining on me. Smiling or something. Smiling and shining. I love it. Acid's a sweet one. Computer case crews have their own Wikipedia page. Oh my god, I'm sure they do. Think about being like a repair dude and having like a bajillion different screws. You gotta look up some information. Where do you go? Wikipedia, man. These guys are fire? Does that mean they're weak to ice? Hopefully. They do. I know you're not joking. It's probably a really important page. Combination with that wizard in the back. Ooh, fire bombs! Oh, they're so sweet! Oh, wow, I was dead. Yeah! Oh, all these powerful elements really make the game interesting. This is a lot different than the last playthrough. Last playthrough, I was like, rip through, speed run, no crafting, nothing. This one got lots of crafted things, and now that they all do stuff. You're frozen. Ah. There. Take a firebomb and an ice top hat. An ice top hat for dessert. For that's nothing. Calculate pi by throwing frozen hot dogs. That's... Oh, it's a WikiHow. I thought that was like an actual wiki page. Wikipedia. Little bastards. Yes. Poison ghost sword is sweet. Wait, so if I hit these guys with a firebomb, will they heal? Nope. I think they just... Oh, he did! That guy healed a little bit. But still, the overriding damage was the bomb effect, so... Yeah, I'm not too concerned about the elements being the healing elements. What I am concerned about so far is that ice. It's really, really... Can really get you by getting hit with multiple ices in a row. Something was really difficult about that fight. That nice quote. How to apologize to a cat? I'm probably a natural at that. I got really good cat energy. It's probably because we had a cat growing up. Yay, that's really good. The shield towers are a lot better now. They go down when they're supposed to. How to become the Pope. Oh, wait, I'm hitting him with poison. Does that mean that he's healing? I gotta check this. You just wanna hang out up there, huh? Off the screen? Okay, so that was doing -2 damage. Actually, I think he might be healing. Because this guy was too easy before. So, if you do rely too much on your ghost sword, I think you might not kill him. You gotta use bombs or the sword. There needs to be a page on what to do when your cat rejects your apology. How to tell your parents you're becoming a Satanist? Man, there's some really useful articles on that website. Yeah, he did heal. Okay, that confirmed it. Alright. So, that's good, because this guy was too easy before, I think. Let's hit him with a few bombs. Into an argument over Harry Potter. I do believe this guy is more interesting now to fight. You happen to have acid. Oh, bad timing. Maybe he should have more Zerubs. Or maybe he should have twice the Zerubs if he's at half health. That might make him harder. Oops. What's up, Clock? Is hitting a bomb with your top hat to manually detonate a possible feature? That's kind of cool. Actually, what I want to try, it's on my list, is to make it so your top hat can pick up bombs. And I also want to try being able to hit bombs with your sword and make them go flying away. And then once they land, they bomb. So it would be your sword more that would make them manually detonate. You would kind of like golf chip almost, like your the bomb, or just, you know, swing your sword at the bomb. It flies a little distance and then explodes. Yes, exactly. You can, so that would make it very dangerous, right? You would either you would catch it on the way back and it would blow you up, or if you catch it on the way out with the right timing, it could be a very, very useful thing. So I think that might actually be a really hidden item. So like you would get this item and then you'd be able to pick up bombs with your top hat. So it would kind of be more for advanced players. Like you're like, oh, I'm an advanced player. I'm going to get that item. And then you'd be able to do some tricky stuff. Maybe find some cool glitches. But I think just regularly being able to hit the bombs with your sword would kind of be interesting. And that, I don't think there would be a special item for that. I don't know, just an experiment, something I'm going to try pretty soon and see how it goes and what it needs, if it is going to be something in the game. Sword, and that's really not good. Man, either I suck or he's a lot harder. What is his health at? Can't really see his health because it flies off screen. Damn, bad timing. what I got. I guess ice is a pretty good thing to hit him with. If only he, if he slowed down with ice, that would kind of be cool. Oh, he has ice resistance, though. Like he's invincible. I really need to check how much health he's gaining. Ah, what's going on? What is going on? That was weird. He's still doing it! Ah, and then I died. I think that's gonna be it for today's stream. I'm about to fall asleep here. I gotta get some dinner and stuff. But that gotta note this. That was actually way harder. That was like super duper hard. So acid boss plus acid ghost sword equals impossible. I'm not sure how much health he's gaining. I need to focus on that, like making the debug tools a little bit. A little bit better, so I can see how much health he's actually gaining and all that. Yeah. So once again, I appreciate you all so much. Thanks for all your comments and suggestions and stuff. Anyways, we'll see y'all next time. Update coming out tonight, hopefully. I might have to do it tomorrow. There's a lot of new little bugs and stuff. So, cheers, everybody. See ya.